Hello, everybody, and welcome to this week's warm-up. For this week's warm-up, I'm coming at you from Dawson Park. I'm here in Northeast Portland, about a block from Emmanuel Hospital. And today, I'm going to be filming our warm-up here in Dawson Park. But you're saying, Mr. Rittman, this park isn't as big or, you know, as fancy as some of the other parks here in Portland. But it is Black History Month, and out of all the parks in Portland, this park right here plays more of an important role in the history of African-American people here in Portland than any other park in Portland. Now, there's three things I want to show you today. I want to tell you about that onion gazebo over here. I want to tell you about these rounded rocks over here. And then I want to tell you about some artwork over here on the fence. I had a whole little speech prepared about things I was going to tell you about this park. But as I was reading these rocks here, I'm going to let the rocks tell you some of that history for me. On these rounded stones right here, you will find quotes from people who grew up in this area who remember this park in the early days. I'm going to read two of these stones to you that tell you a little history about this area here. Neighborhood children had long used the empty lot for football, baseball, and other games. The city of Portland purchased the Dutard Track in 1921, which is 100 years ago, formally developing it as a local playground. The park was later named Dawson Park for the local reformer, Reverend John Dawson, an advocate for child welfare and civic improvement in the 1920s. In the 1960s, social justice was a focal point for the local community. Marches and rallies protesting the Vietnam War and the repression of civil rights often started at Dawson Park.
As I mentioned, this park is in what was historically a African-American neighborhood, and in the 1950s and 60s, many social justice rallies started right here, and then they would go on their marches. One notable person that did come to this park was Robert Kennedy in 1968 during his presidential campaign. He ran on a platform of racial and social justice issues. After years of gentrification and redlining, a lot of African-American people were pushed out of this neighborhood. In 2013, the city of Portland decided to revamp this park. And there's a few things that I want to point out that they did during that remodel during 2013. One was those stones that I already showed you. A second thing was the onion gazebo. It used to sit atop the Hill Building, which was two blocks down the street. But years ago, Emmanuel Hospital wanted to expand. They knocked down the entire block. And they did save this onion gazebo, and they brought it down here to help represent what was here at one time. The other thing I'm gonna show you is some artwork that is over here on the playground. One cool thing they did in 2013 during the renovation was hire a artist, and I'm gonna put the name here at the bottom because I don't wanna butcher this name, but they came in and that artist put in African art on the other side of these panels here, and on this side you see important figures in African American history.
Here's a collection of still images that I took while standing on the playground of the African art that is on the other side of these images, which I was just showing you. These are super cool images, but the one thing I wish is that I could find information on exactly who these people are in these images. I couldn't find that information. Let's now jump into our warm-up. The first thing I want you to do is swing one leg back and then swing it up and touch it with your opposite hand. Next, I want you to bring one knee up and hug it into you. Then switch, bring the other knee up. We're gonna go back and forth, right to left. Next, we're gonna do lunges. I want you to lunge down and bring your opposite elbow to your opposite knee. So I'm lunging with my left knee, bringing my right elbow across. Lunging with my right knee, bringing my left elbow across. Next up, we're gonna do a dynamic variation of a one-legged deadlift. You're gonna balance on one leg, bring the other leg up, touch your toes with the opposite hand. Ooh, 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 come on, baby.
next, I want you to cross your arms across your chest. Every time you cross your arms, switch which arm you have on top. Next, we're gonna do trunk twists. Spread your arms out wide and swing them side to side. Next, we're gonna do a trunk twist variation. You're gonna keep twisting, but this time you're gonna bend at the hips as you do so. All right, go ahead and stand up. Small arm circles forward. And big arm circles. Small arm circles backwards. And big arm circles backwards. Next up, high knees in place. Think about it. There must be a higher love. Down in the heart or hidden in the stars above. Without it, life is a wasted time. Switch it up to kickbacks. Put your hands behind your hips and kick your heels to your palms. Things look so bad everywhere. Next up is straight leg stride while standing in the same spot. Kick your legs up straight. Let's round out today's warm up with some jumping jacks.
All right, everybody, thank you for warming up with me here at Dawson Park. If you want to learn more about this park, I encourage you to Google Dawson Park, Portland, Oregon. Learn some of the history at this place. If you're ever free on a nice sunny day on a weekend, come visit this park. Read some of these stones here. Bring your family here. When it's not coronavirus time, there's concerts here. They have a yearly jambalaya contest here. So I encourage you to come to Dawson Park at some point.